Hi, I'm Katie Dean, a registered dietitian, and we're here at Brookshire's Grocery Store in West Monroe today to pick up the items that we need for our caramel cheesecake bites. The items on our grocery list today are almond flour, Truvia baking blend, Smart Balance light butter, and cream cheese. So the first item on our healthy substitution list for the cheesecake is almond flour. Now you're probably not going to find almond flour in the regular baking aisle at the grocery store, so we're here at the special gluten-free section. Almond flour is really healthy for you and it allows this cheesecake to be gluten-free. Gluten-free almond flour is higher in protein and heart-healthy monounsaturated fat. It's higher in protein and fat than the regular white flour. It's made, of course, from whole almonds, and almonds are really healthy for us, so it has that same nutritional component as almonds do. It's also high in fiber and vitamin E. Crystal's using 1/3 less fat cream cheese for the cheesecake today. Just by substituting the lower fat cream cheese for the regular version, you save about 30 calories and 3 grams of fat per ounce. This cheesecake recipe calls for a lot of cream cheese, I think around 19 ounces. So just by subbing the lower fat cream cheese, you save almost 600 calories and over 60 grams of fat just for this one recipe. The next item on our grocery list is Smart Balance light butter. This butter has 50% less fat and saturated fat than regular butter or stick margarine. This one's made with flaxseed oil, which makes it high in omega-3 fatty acids, which actually raise your good cholesterol levels. Crystal's using Truvia baking blend in the cheesecake recipe today. By using this baking blend, you can cut down on about 75% of the calories from the sugar from the recipe. It's a blend of regular sugar and Truvia, then more natural sweetener. So it's a great option in this recipe. So now let's get to the fast food kitchen and watch Crystal as she prepares this recipe.
Hello and welcome to the Fast Food Kitchen. Today we're going to be making a tasty gluten-free treat, caramel cheesecake bites. It's very simple, but there's two parts to it. The first part we're going to do is make the crust. It's a little different than your traditional graham cracker crust because it's gluten-free. But we're going to take almond flour, it's milled almond flour, about a cup, and we're going to pour it into the bowl. This is a little more than a cup, so I'm going to leave a little bit in there. I over-measured earlier, but it's about a cup right there. And then we're also going to mix in half a cup of crushed almonds. I had bought the slivered, and then I put them in pulsed them in the food processor for just a few pulses to kind of blend it up. But it gives it a great texture and also great nutrition. So we're going to kind of stir that up, and then we're going to add 1/4 cup of Smart Balance light butter. I like the one with the flaxseed. I just like to know there's, you know, some kind of good nutrition in what I'm eating. But that's going to help bind it together there, so we're going to kind of stir that. This is going to make our crust. You're also going to add 1/4 teaspoon of fine sea salt. You don't want the coarse in this particular one. And then 1/4 teaspoon of baking powder, not baking soda. 1/4 teaspoon of cinnamon. That is our magic number today. Just kind of mix that in there to where all of the ingredients get around. This is going to bond together for your crust. And you're also going to add 2 heaping tablespoons of the Truvia baking blend. The original recipe called for like 1/4 cup of sugar, but I use the Truvia baking blend to cut down a little bit on the sugar and the calories. And it bakes just as good as sugar and everything I've ever used it in. So you're going to mix that in there. And this, like I said, this is going to make your crust. And we're going to take the mini muffin cups. That makes a better size. So I have these over here. So we're going to take this. And you can use the liners if you like. It saves on cleaning, and especially if you're having guests over. It's really great because it's just, you can pop them right out and set them on the plate or the tray, and it looks really nice. But you're going to form, they're going to be a little crumbly at first, but once you press them down into the pan like that, we'll just do a couple here. Just kind of put it in there, and you're going to press them down. And before you start, you just want to preheat your oven to 350. And once we fill, we don't have time for that today, but you'll fill all your muffin tins full of the, and you have it pressed down there, but you'll fill them up. And then you'll put it in the oven for about 10 minutes to get it set, and it'll make it stay together. And when you're while you're doing that, you can start on your cream cheese filling, which is 4 ingredients. It's super simple. So we'll do that real quick. And what we're going to do is take about 19 ounces of cream cheese. Stick that in there. And you can use the reduced fat cream cheese to cut back on the calories as well and the fat. It still has pretty good flavor. So you put that in there, and then we're going to take pure vanilla extract. You're going to do a teaspoon of that. And then we're going to also add 3 eggs. Have the natural organic free range eggs. Just going to crack a few. Oop, why'd I do that? Let's stick it on into the trash can. Just like that. All right, and then it's only got one more ingredient for the filling. It's very simple. We're going to, again, we're going to use the same amount, 1/4 a cup, or substitution for the sugar, 2 tablespoons of the Trivia Bacon Blend. So we're going to dump that in there. And then it's just, you're going to blend it up. Raise this thing up here. Down on the sides here, it's kind of sticking. One more go around, we should be good to go. All right, and that's it. And all you do is you'll obviously spoon all of it in. We're just going to do a couple. We're going to spoon it in on top of the preset. Remember, you want your crust preset. I didn't do that step, but make sure you do that. Release this down here. There we go. And you're going to just get one little scoop here. I'm going to scoop in just a little bit of that. Still not quite where I needed it to be, but I'm just going to scoop it in there over here. And you're going to fill it all the way up, about 3/4 full. And then what you'll do is you'll put it, once you fill all your preset crust in with the cream cheese filling, put it in there for 40 minutes until it'll be about done at that time. Pull it back out and you'll just let it cool for a little bit. It's going to kind of indent as well and sink down. And that's right where you want to put your pre-filled caramel. You are more than welcome to make homemade caramel, but I just go for the easy. I got this salted caramel just to put on top of it. And it's great, like I said, for parties or whatever you need it for. But I have a pan that I've already made over here, and I have some guests in the studio with me today. I have Brian, our occupational therapist. He works here at the Health Management Affinity Center with me, and also Teresa, our physical therapist assistant. So they're going to come try these. I got y'all some here today. If y'all just want to eat them with your hand, however you want to do it, I have forks, but they're just, like I said, they're super cute, super easy. You can just peel the little papers back. I like doing it with the papers because it just makes it really easy, especially if you're hosting a party or something. And just a couple little bite treat. And gluten-free, great. You want another one? Go for it. Brian's going to clean my plate off. So, all right. Well, thank y'all for coming in today, and thank y'all for joining us in the Fast Food Kitchen. Join us next time for another healthy and tasty treat.